Introducing AutoTAC LC-MS. The AutoTAC LC-MS interface is an on-surface autosampler for liquid chromatography mass spectrometry. It enables direct typhination of planar chromatography and LC-MS, as well as fully automated zone elution and sequence analysis. Template-based zone targeting and positioning is possible via simple clicks on the image. Our complete TAC-HPLC-HRMS setup consists of a mini PC controlling the AutoTAC-LC-MS interface, as well as a monolithic column that was directly installed in between the interface and the mass spectrometer, in this case an Orbitrap HRMS system. An HPLC pump is providing the alien flow to the interface. In our experiment, we prepared two plates in parallel. A mixture of 8 multi-class antibiotics was applied in triplicate as a 5-level calibration band pattern on both of the plates. The plate on the left was intended for the HRMS measurement, whereas the plate on the right was subjected to the Bacillus subtilis bioassay and served as a template for automated zone elution. The antibiotic zones are visible as bright spots on a reddish background. The 5x10 cm plate for HRMS was mounted in the versatile multi-format plate holder with the help of an additional glass plate to avoid shifting of the plate during the measurement. The AutoTAC-LC-MS interface is controlled by an open source software termed TAC-MS Manager. The image of our template plate can be easily uploaded into the software. After selection of the interesting area on the left side, the area is displayed enhanced on the right side. The zones for elution are simply chosen by clicking on the bright bands on the enhanced image. The chosen elution zones are then translated into a badge displayed on the bottom left of the screen. Before starting the measurement, the AutoTAC-LC-MS interface has to be prepared. The motors responsible for the plate holder movement have to be homed to synchronize software and hardware. The positioning bias for each individual plate has to be adjusted. For this purpose, the plate holder is moved to one of the chosen elution zones. The position of the interface's laser crosshair indicates whether the hardware and software are correctly aligned. If this is not the case, the assumed bias can be directly entered in the X and Y bias fields or, alternatively, can be adjusted by clicking on the plus or minus fields on the right. After adjustment, correct positioning can be checked by moving the plate holder to some of the selected elution zones. Various elution profiles suitable for different setups can be chosen and also adapted if necessary. All commands before batch are only performed once before the batch. All commands between head are performed repeatedly in between each elution. All commands after batch are only performed once after the batch. Elution and pausing times suitable for the analytes must be selected. The batch can be documented by downloading the elution order and the chosen positions as a CSV file. Now everything is ready for automated batch-wise zone elution. The interface automatically moves to the first elution position, lowers the elution head and switches the 6-port valve to elute the analytes from the plate directly into the monolithic column. The start signal for the HPAC pump for starting the chromatographic run is provided by the interface, short before the elution head is lowered. After 30 seconds, the 6-port valve is rotated back into bypass position. The elution head is cleaned to remove adherent silica gel particles, and gradient separation follows for 9.5 minutes. After a full chromatographic run was performed, the interface proceeds with the next elution zone. After the measurement, the imprinted plate was subjected to the Bacillus subtilis bioassay. Comparison of the two images before and after elution confirms the correct positioning of the elution head. It was possible to rapidly separate 8 multi-class antibiotics shown by their extracted ion chromatograms. For further information, please refer to the following literature.